Omajnanatamirandasya Dhananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyatya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaurabhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So this is a description of the different inauspicious signs appearing in nature when the birth of Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu is imminent. So just before their birth, so many inauspicious signs are appearing in nature. Just like in this verse we are seeing the auspicious planets like Mercury, Jupiter or Venus, their brightness decreased. They were not very brightly shining. Whereas the inauspicious planets like Saturn and Mars, they became more brilliant and they were shining. So when they are shining, one should understand that there are very inauspicious signs. So that means the whole natural processes became topsy-turvy. Everything was disturbed in the nature when these two demoniac people are taking birth. It's very simple to understand. Just like, suppose if there is a prime minister or a president of the country, he is coming to a certain place because he is a very important man, very important person. We find that the all different machineries of the government, they will come into action immediately to see to it that the different conditions are favorable for his arrival. If the president is coming, if the prime minister is coming, all the government machineries will move in such a way. Suppose, just like if you can see, we were waiting for this road to be completed from very long time and we had been asking, so many requests we have been giving but they were not heeding. But now because they are planning an opening and minister, some important minister is going to come, so you can see the work is going on very fast. Everything happens. So they all become very favorable. Whereas imagine if instead of prime minister or president, if there is a big dacoit or a big rover or underground, you know, Don is coming. Then instead of making it favorable, everything will be made unfavorable so that he cannot go away. So that he can be captured, he can be put behind the bars. Right? Similarly, we can see when Lord Krishna or when the incarnation of the Lord, when they arrive in the material world, yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharatam. So whenever the Lord has to come, then everything becomes very, very auspicious. The planets, they change their places in such a way that everything becomes very, very favorable, very auspicious. And opposite we are seeing, instead of the Supreme Lord or His incarnation, or when a pure devotee of the Lord, representative of the Lord comes, then everything becomes very favorable. And when opposite, a demoniac person is coming, then everything becomes very, very unfavorable. Similarly, opposite is also true. When a great personality comes in this material world, everything is auspicious. When a great personality departs from this material world, everything becomes inauspicious. Of course, for devotees, we have to understand there is even the disappearance of a great acharya is actually, there is no such difference for a devotee. But of course, a devotee laments. Just like we sing that song, Jaya Nilo Prema Dhana, right? So, the devotee is not very happy when a great acharya disappears. And actually we see that when a great acharya disappears, then at least for certain time, there is discrepancies. When Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur disappeared, there were fights in Gaudiya Math. When Prabhupada disappeared from this earth, we are seeing that his mission was also hijacked by some very ambitious disciples. So that is definitely there. When a great personality, even when Lord Krishna disappeared from this earth, there were so many inauspicious signs. When Maharaj Yudhishthir saw that Arjuna has not returned for a long time, and he started observing, the whole chapter you can see in the first canto, so many inauspicious signs Maharaj Yudhishthir was able to see. So he was able to visualize that actually the Lord has wound off his pastime. Whereas when the Lord appeared, you know, the explanation is given in the 10th canto how everything became very, very auspicious. The constellation, the nakshatras, the stars, everything became very, very auspicious. Whereas when the Lord disappeared, it is very inauspicious. Everything became inauspicious. And when the Lord was present here, and when the Lord was glancing, everything was auspicious. Everything was flourishing. Hi edante tav vikshitaihi, Kunti Maharani says. Ime janapada supradaha. So everything was very, very auspicious. Everything was flourishing. Rivers were filled with waters. There were proper rains. There were proper crops. So everything was flourishing. But we see that when the Supreme Lord disappears from this earth, everything becomes imbalanced. So what do we actually understand from this? So a very important factor we can understand, either when a great acharya or the Supreme Lord, when they are present, then everything is auspicious, everything is flourishing. When a great acharya is absent, or when the Supreme Lord is absent, the whole world actually becomes dead. So it's very simple to understand. Prabhupada gives the example. It is just like this body. As long as there is soul inside this body is active, filled with so many different kinds of activities. It is flourishing, it is healthy. But the moment the soul is absent, it fades away, it goes away. The beauty goes away, everything goes away. Health goes away. Similarly, one should understand, if Krishna is present in this material world, then everything will be flourishing. If Krishna glances, if His mercy is there, then everything will be flourishing, everything will be auspicious. The moment we make Krishna absent from our life, it's very true. From our life, if we make Krishna absent, from the society, if we make Krishna absent, our life will also become dead, even though we will be breathing. We'll be breathing. But actually, without Krishna consciousness, life is dead. Similarly, we may find so much of advancement in this material world, but if Krishna is absent, if there is no Krishna consciousness, then actually the society is dead. It is only inauspicious. Everything we can find inauspicious. So what do we understand by this? So we understand a very important point. If we want, if we want sarve janah sukhino bhavantu, if we want everyone to be happy, including ourselves, whole society to be happy, all living entities to be happy, then the only process is the whole world has to become Krishna conscious. If the world is filled with Krishna consciousness, then we can find that actually everything will be satisfied. If the world is devoid of Krishna consciousness, we may try everything possible to make the world united, to make the world satisfied, to make the world a place of heaven, a happy world. It will not be possible. It is just like as simple as till the branch is connected to the original tree, till that time it will be flourishing. The moment you disconnect the branch from the tree, it will dry up in no time. It may look like it is still alive. In no time it will dry up. Similarly, if the whole society is connected to Krishna in Krishna consciousness, then we can find that everything will be very, very peaceful. It will be Ram Rajya. People talk about Ram Rajya, Ram Rajya. They have to be connected. When the world becomes disconnected, it is only Ravana Rajya. It's not Ram Rajya. We may talk about Ram Rajya, but it will not be Ram Rajya. Ram Rajya will come because of the presence of Lord Rama. So, presence of Lord Krishna or Rama, when it is there in the society, then everything will be flourishing. So this is a very, very important factor we should understand in our life. Devotee in his personal life also understands this, that actually if I am not happy, devotee has no lamentation whatsoever, actually speaking. Whatever may happen in this material world, in his material life, devotee is never lamenting, nor is he hankering. If a devotee sees that actually there is lamentation, I am put into miseries, I am finding my mind is agitated, I am seeing that so many problems are there, I am facing so many problems, that means lack of Krishna consciousness. Very simple thing. Material things are only instruments. This is creating problem, that is creating problem, that devotee is giving me a lot of trouble. These are all nothing. Prabhupada, when he was there, how many people tried to give problems? Right? How many problems you can see? But Prabhupada was never disturbed like that. Why? Because when Krishna is present in our life, then there is no question of disturbances. So, in our life also, if we find there are inauspiciousness, there are miseries, there are kleshas, problems, anxieties, tensions, then we should understand somehow we have made
Krishna absent in our life, Maya present in our life. Maya is present, don't think she will always, you know, Maya is a kicking master. Prabhupada used to say, you make your master as Maya, then you can only think about getting kicks from Maya. Isn't it? So, we have to understand like this, that if a devotee is actually in turmoil, he is facing problems, his mind is agitated, and varieties of anxieties are there in his life, that means there is a lack of Krishna consciousness, and we should work in that direction. The moment we become actually Krishna conscious, there is no question that actually devotee is not jubilant. Isn't it? So this is one very, very important point we can understand. Another important point a devotee understands is, just like in Bhagavad Gita, this example is given by Arjuna himself to make all of us understand that actually no material counteraction can actually solve this material inauspiciousness. Varieties of disturbances we are facing, either in our own life or either in this material world, we cannot counteract them. Devotee understands this thoroughly. Prabhupada gives this example that actually material miseries are not ordinary miseries. Nobody wants. Let us say, if some of us are disturbed in our mind, some problems are there in our mind. How many of us actually wanted problems? None of us. We always want to get out of these problems. But still we find so difficult. Problems are not going away. And sometimes we feel, possibly only when I end my life, only problems will go. And we think, let me end my life. No. Still problems will not go away. Problems will still remain. Why? Because material consciousness is remaining. Till material consciousness is there, it will continue existence. Till we become Krishna conscious, material existence will continue. So problems will not be solved. So the example is given, material problems, kleshas in this material world, miseries in this material world, disturbances in this material world, or in our life, they are compared to forest fire. Forest fire, this example is given to make us understand, no solution. At least there is no solution. With my endeavor, there is no possibility. So this example is given to make us understand, forest fire, two very important things. Nobody wants it. Nobody goes and puts. And nobody can, with our endeavor, nobody can put it off. So no one wants it. And nobody goes and puts on a forest fire. It automatically happens. And nobody can put it off. So devotee understands. Material problems, disturbances in our life, it is like this. I don't want. I never invited those problems. I thought everything will be fine. But I am seeing everything is opposite. Exactly like Arjuna felt. This is all material calculation. Arjuna also thought like that. I will go to fight, everything will be fine. And I will be able to finish them off. So he's telling Krishna, Krishna, put my chariot in the middle. Let me see who are these people. With so much enthusiasm he went. But afterward, hands are shivering. Mind is reeling. He's not able to stand. And he said, Krishna, I cannot fight. Everything is vipritani. What I thought, what I calculated, it is all opposite. So this is material world, one should understand. You try to solve it materially, everything will be vipritani. Everything will be opposite. Because it is not possible. Just like if you want to think, I will go and set right that forest fire, let me take few buckets, let me take fire brigade, it is not possible. So just like forest fire can be doused, it can be put off, only with external factor. If there is good rain, if there is a heavy rain, the forest fire can immediately be extinguished. Similarly, if there is possibility of getting the rain mercy of spiritual master, the pure devotee of the Lord, then there is possibility that we can come out of this material existence. Otherwise, there is no possibility. With our endeavor, if we are thinking I'll be able to solve my problem, it is not possible. So, devotee does not try some counteraction in that sense. In the material world, everybody tries a counteraction. Prabhupada gives an example. You fall sick, you try a counteraction. You'll go to the doctor. So, does it mean devotee, when he falls sick, he'll not go to the doctor? That is not the idea. The devotee does his duty, whatever is required. But he is not dependent on the counteraction. Mare Krishna rakhe ke, rakhe Krishna mare ke. He has this understanding. If Krishna does not want to save me, no counteraction can save me. If I fall sick, best of the doctors can come, best of the medicines I can take. But if Krishna does not sanction, none of these things can save me. I may have the best of the captains, I may have the best of the ship, best of the facilities on the ship. Still, if Krishna does not sanction, I will drown. Correct? So, a devotee, apart from doing his duty, he does not go around and thinking these material things will save me. Whatever is best is possible from his side, he tries and he leaves rest to the Lord. He is not busy in trying to counteract the different material forces of this material world. Rather, he tries to tolerate them. Krishna is saying, what is there? Just like in today's world, we are seeing if there is a heat, they'll develop fan, they'll develop AC. So many counteractions we are trying. And then the whole material civilization is, after this, if you go and ask people, why don't you come for the class? Where is the time? Why? We are all busy with counteraction. All busy for counteraction. Material for, you know, struggle for existence. We are all struggling for existence. So Vedic literature says, why are you struggling so hard? Of course, what can be done? Now the world is like this, now we cannot say, no fans are required, no nothing is required. Just like I was giving that example in the other class, somebody was asking Prabhupada, you are saying that all these material things are anartha, useless, then why are you using this mic? So Prabhupada said, this mic was useless, I made it useful. Isn't it? So similarly, it's not that we have to criticize like that. We understand the more the civilization goes in this direction, there is no end to it. It will go on like this. Just trying to counteract. And the result is we forget the goal of life. We are only busy in counteraction. Real counteraction method, that we forget. That real counteraction of everything is Krishna consciousness, not this material thing. Material thing, as far as possible, we try to adjust. More than that, we tolerate. That should be the idea. More than that, we should just try to tolerate it. So this is how a devotee understands, not like materialistic people who spend their whole life only in counteracting these different disturbances. So this is another very important thing which we can understand from this thing. So here we are seeing Prabhupada is explaining in the purport. The entire universe is moving under the three modes of material nature. So everything in this material world is controlled by material nature. So till we are under the influence of the material nature, actually speaking, nothing is auspicious. But even in this material world, which is considered to be inauspicious, andhkara, when there is light of knowledge of Krishna consciousness, then even this becomes bright. Everything becomes auspicious. So in that sense, for a devotee, nothing is auspicious or inauspicious. Auspiciousness is defined by when everything is utilized in the service of the Lord, even inauspicious things become auspicious. And if we give up Krishna consciousness, then even auspicious things become inauspicious. Just like there is a saying in Bengali, Muchi hoy suchi ei Krishna bhaje. Even a muchi, even unclean, unhygienic man, even he becomes completely purified if he takes to Krishna consciousness. Shuchi hoy muchi yehi Krishna taje. Whereas Brahmana, he may be Brahmana with all hygiene, everything is there. But if he gives up Krishna consciousness, then he also becomes a muchi. So that means everything becomes inauspicious. So if we understand this principle, then actually in that sense nothing is inauspicious in this material world. We will be able to utilize everything in propagating Krishna consciousness. We'll stop with this. Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Yes. 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 Correct.
Everything was toxic orbit.
Yes.
And today we are going to compare to that of
Dwapara
Yuga. Yes. And terrorism activities, pollution is worse for everything now.
Yes.
And a day may come when we would this TV news and all that. They are just giving us, cautioning us, saying that the pollution is in a rapid speed. The day may come that we may not get the proper air to breathe in. So
we'll have to carry cylinders with us.
Yes. But the thing is, when such things are going on, so whether Krishna is not now present, then such things are there. When he was there, everything was flourishing. But when everything is in doldrums now, so whether Krishna
yes. is not present, lack of Krishna consciousness. So wherever his devotees are there, wherever the devotees are singing the glories of the Lord is definitely present. But because practically 99% of people are atheistic, may not be atheistic, religious, but Krishna consciousness is lacking. So because of the lack of Krishna consciousness, we see that everything is topsy-turvy. So the solution we should think is, the more we spread Krishna consciousness, the more we can find that everything will come to order. Just like Prabhupada used to say that when, even though I am in New York, but because in this temple everything is centered around the Lord, so everything is Krishna consciousness. So we are still in Vrindavan. We are not away from Vrindavan. What is Vrindavan? Everybody is focused on
serving the Supreme Lord, satisfying the Supreme Lord. So this consciousness, if we spread everywhere, then this whole world, material world, will also become Vaikuntha. So that is the lack of Krishna consciousness, because of which we see so many disturbances, everything is topsy-turvy. Whereas you will find in Krishna consciousness, we don't see. Wherever the devotees are following, they are happy. They are still happy. Even though everything outside is going on, so many material problems are going on, but we find that devotees do not have such struggle for existence like outside people are struggling. Very much. Krishna is present. Wherever his devotees are glorifying, there he is present. Now we have to make Krishna present everywhere. Krishna is present, but he is not manifest. So we have to make him manifest by congregational chanting, by Sankirtana movement. The more we spread Krishna consciousness, the Lord has come in the form of holy name. The more we propagate, the more people chant, then the Lord will be there, his mercy will be there. So these 10,000 years will become golden period. Even in Kali Yuga, when the Sankirtana movement will spread, even in Kali Yuga, this will become a golden age. So that depends on the devotees. Sometimes the Lord is, he reserves his mercy. But devotees are more merciful than even Krishna. They are unreserved. Even to the most fallen, they are ready to give mercy. Just like Nityananda Prabhu, he gave to Jagayan Madhai. And Prabhupada, by the mercy of Lord Nityananda, he gave that mercy to thousands of Jagais and Madhais. So now following in his footsteps, we have to give the mercy of Prabhupada to lakhs and lakhs of Jagai and Madhais. It is very much possible, provided we follow what Prabhupada says. Gantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jaya jagat guru shila Prabhupada ki jaya.